Hey up, I'm back for part two of episode 5 of The Haunting of Bly Manor. Let's watch.
Cross one of its traps and there's something in it. Something quite small. Not a mouse mind. Caterpillar, I thought, maybe. And I pick it up and look at it. It was a leg. Bloody mouse leg. Poor mouse was a few feet away. It chewed its own leg off to escape the trap. Poor thing bled to death.
Oh, that actually sounds fucking awful.
That man is a glue trap. And when Rebecca realises that she won't come up whole, she'll think she's okay. Till she realises she's stuck. Denial.
I'm looking at this as an opportunity.
This actress is amazing. I need to find out her name. And we're back in this same moment again.
Great learning experience.
We've done this before.
We need a cooker in to stay on.
Again and again.
When the time comes, I won't go running off. I promise you that.
He's changed his...
I'll be stuck in this glue trap of a town just like everyone else. You're familiar with glue traps?
We talked about that once.
Yeah.
Not yet, we haven't. Technically. But I thought about it for weeks after we did. Thought about what that must feel like. That glue. Setting in.
Oh, I've got chills.
Before we really know it. That bottomless, icy terror. Realizing that we may be stuck forever. Do you think a mouse is capable of that kind of realization?
Well, I don't know.
Do we realize when we're in the glue? Or when the water around us is boiling? Or do we sit there saying this will be okay? I'm okay. Denial!
It's morbid. God, that's what this is. This is morbid.
Be careful.
It's morbid.
What does it all mean?
So I need you to pack your bags and be ready to go tomorrow night.
What are you talking about? I can't just...
Please, just do that for me. And I promise I'll explain everything.
Don't do shit for him.
Can you trust me?
No. Yet again, I absolutely do not. Except Hannah's stood in your room right now.
And then I'm coming back here for you, I promise.
Quick, Hannah, kill him before he can come back.
I love you.
It's all so convincing. That is really sweet.
A lord and his lady. No, a queen and her stable boy.
I mean, that's true. She is a queen and you are a stable boy. Well, no, stable boys are still good people. You're the shit on the stable boy's shoes.
I haven't seen you in this one before, though. What are you doing here? How did you slip into my...
I'm so sorry. Miss, I'm so sorry.
No, I wouldn't go out there. I think this is when it happened. I can never bring myself to what...
I'm so sorry, Miss Hannah. I'm so sorry.
You do not.
Oh.
You can sleep.
You heard something.
Oh, Hannah. You scared me, girl. She's back there again.
I thought I circled back to bed.
Yes! Yes! I fuck whoever this bitch is, you go for it. Yes! 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 I'm so happy. It might seem really fucked up, but I am so happy. Oh, so he's now a ghost. And they can clearly see him because he's a ghost.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
Oh my God. Seeing yourself. I don't like him, so I don't feel bad for him at all. Don't touch the boy. Shit, she went into the boy. That's why Miles is a dick. I mean, I actually love it. I stan this ghost lady. Drag him into the lake. Yeah. Go for it. And Hannah has always known this, so she has always counted him as among the dead. But the candle could mean multiple things now. I'm not really on it. This is my fucking dream. Who are you?
I'm looking at this as an opportunity.
Oh, we're back again.
In Paris, I was a sous chef.
Please, I need a fucking ending.
One more time. You are Hannah Gross. The year is 1987. You're at Bly. Dominic is dead. Charlotte is dead. Rebecca is dead. Peter is missing, you think?
Peter is eight. Dead.
And Miles.
Peter is in Miles.
Is wrong with Miles.
This is really annoying now because I want Miles to die. No, not Miles, the Peter version of him.
For fuck's sake, woman! Why can't you just leave well enough alone?
Shut the fuck up, Miles, Peter.
Nope. Most of the time. But not right
Piles.
Now. And believe me, nothing would make me happier than to be arrested by those police you're talking about. To be dragged off this fucking property! Away from this god awful trap! But I can't! Can I?
We need to get him out of the boy, man.
Because?
You're dead.
It's such a shame that you had to go and follow us. It was going so well.
Follow us?
Honestly, Hannah!
No! No! Oh my God, please be okay! In this moment again.
We can't count on the past. That's what I learned. Taking care of Mum. It's kind of what dementia is, isn't it?
Oh, this episode.
Maybe not. But that's the biggest thing.
And that it brings me back to this.
The past. I mean, we think we have it trapped in our memories, but
wow.
Memories fade. We could fade at any time.
Wow.
Thank you. Wait.
No, they're about to leave.
Please.
Well, good.
Cheer me, Sif. I am fucking gone. Fully gone.
Ellen, wait.
No, don't.
Wait. You had a grocery store, 1987, you're at Y. Miles is 10, floor is 8. You were... You were Hannah Gross.
You are Hannah Gross.
You are Hannah Gross.
Cope with this show, man. It's way too much. Wow. Let me just turn this off. My heart is in pieces. Hello, baby. Hannah is dead. I'm so, I'm feeling all of the emotions, all of them. I still don't really understand the time loop, like, that she kept going round and round, but as she just died, like, in this right time right now, so I feel like the next episode they're gonna see a dead body or something. I'm so mad, I hated him, and the fact that it literally keeps fucking me up this year, honestly. It's one of the best things I've watched in a while, though. Even though I don't like scary stuff. Honestly, I'm a mess. A huge mess. Nah, mate. Absolutely fucking not. It's not fair. I wanted Peter to die and Hannah to survive. Fucking Miles, like, I know it's not Miles, but still. The fact that he's in, like, using the boy pisses me off so much. It was a lot. Wow. The actress, man, the actress that plays Hannah. I need to find out her name. Hold on. I need to find out a name. So I've looked up a name and I don't want to say it wrong, but I'm going to try. So Tania Miller, the actress, man, in this episode, every little nuance, little facial expression, little change, she made me feel all the emotions. I'm so in love with her. I'm so heartbroken. It is a lot. So that was my episode, that was my reaction to episode 5 of The Haunting of Bly Manor. I'm a fucking mess. Please join me for the next one and please subscribe and like. Ta-ra!